The transgender community is still fighting to find its place in society. During the pandemic, it is one community that is facing serious challenges in finding a secure source of livelihood. But there are people who have gone a step ahead, supported them through their journeys and helped them find work which is enabling, which is productive and extremely beautiful. I have with me Purnima Sukumar, director of Arvani Art Project, who has been supporting the transgender community to come up with beautiful mural paintings, and I'm pleased to have her with me on Art Stories. When Purnima discovered her passion for art, she decided not to restrict it to herself. Neither did she view it as something which is a prerogative for a select few. And this drive to take art out and make it accessible for all became her vision. In her journey, Purnima worked on a documentary on the transgender community. And even after when the film was over, Purnima felt a strong urge to continue working with this group as she felt that they needed more support to gain their identity. It is then she embarked upon her work of taking the art forms to the transgender community and make mural paintings, which she started with a view to create safe spaces for alternative voices through art. The transgender community for long has been struggling for acceptance and continue to face serious discrimination and stigma. The project fosters a spirit of participation as members of this community come together with other members of society. The artwork has given them a source of income, a voice, and has brought forward a lot of awareness. During the pandemic, they have explored alternative ways of creating artwork.
My guest today is someone who has actually chosen the road not taken. She is an artist who has been practicing mural wall decoration and art painting from a very long time. And at the same time, she has worked with a community that is very vulnerable, marginalized, and mostly underrepresented. She's working with the transgender community, not only helping them to find a source of livelihood, but also helping them find dignity in what they do. I'm very, very pleased to have with me Purnima Sukumar here. She is the director of Arvani Art Project, something very unique and progressive in itself. And welcome Purnima on Her Story. Purnima, if I have to ask you that your project has been running for quite a while. If you could tell us something about the beginning, what was the genesis of the project? And for the years that you have been the transgender, meaning in what they are doing by making these mural art wall paintings?
I studied painting and I graduated as a fine artist. But I've always been inclined towards painting walls. Although I did not get the right opportunity or exposure to explore that as a medium when I had finished studying. So I just let it subside for some time. Then I got into teaching. And teaching also leads you to learning so much more about, more than what the art is applied as, what people perceive art as, just doing something on canvas and putting it up in galleries. It was interesting for me to include art in so many subjects for children and understand that it's actually something that's very universal and it exists in all walks of life. So my early thoughts on art belonging to everyone started with teaching, and I realized that we have started classifying it as a rich profession or it belongs to a particular class of people because of our own doing, and that was something I was against from the beginning. I didn't want to paint so that I can sell it to really rich clients and it'll only be with them. So actually I stopped practicing art for a while because of that thought process. And okay. Soon when I got into the field of teaching, I realized that art is so beautiful and it's available for so many people. And I don't know why it stops when we become adults. We should continue having like art classes regardless, right? Although these were some of the thoughts that were floating, of course, professionally, I could only stick to one or two things. I got into NID for some time and I learned a little bit of, you know, shooting with a camera, editing and things like that. But soon after I quit NID, I started getting into anthropology, where I documented things for many communities. While I was doing that, I got an opportunity to also work on a documentary, which was related to the transgender community. And the documentary process was for 3.5 years. So I got to become very, very close to the people in the community, and I made very, very good friends, because for 3.5 years, I sort of knew their journey, I knew what they were up to. And the filmmaker was based out of London. So I knew that there was something that I needed to do after the film is done. I just felt like even the documentary was not doing justice to how they live. It was not doing justice to how they feel and how they are perceived by the rest of the society. So I wanted to do something in the art space, and I wanted it to be in public, because everything else that they were doing was inside closed doors, within four walls. And I just wanted this, you know, this beautiful friendship to happen in front of everyone. So, you know, it takes that one person to start it, and everybody else will also start changing their mind slowly. So that's how the project started. So yes, we paint large scale murals in public spaces, often commissioned by government bodies, sometimes commissioned by corporates and private bodies as well. And yeah, now we are a collective since 5 years.
Wow. So I find this very fascinating that you mentioned that art is not something which is very exclusive, that a certain group of people who can manage to pay for it and can have access to it, and at the same time not restricting yourself that once you turn an adult you need not really indulge into art in any form. Yeah. So having that kind of the notion that we all have, that, you know, art is for children, or art is something which is just there in some museum or gallery, but it is, you brought it out in the open. And I really admire the fact that you continued your journey post the documentary also, and helped people in a way that, as you mentioned, they were perceived a certain way, and just making a documentary may not have done justice to the way they are thinking about things around them. So tell us a little about some of the big projects that you have done under the Arvani Art Project, Purnima.
All our projects have been very big, to be honest. But some of the memorable ones would be 2016, we did a very big mural, our first big mural in Bangalore. And that really created a lot of noise and buzz around the whole topic of gender and how it is seen in public spaces. And we painted a portrait of a transgender person for the first time as a mural on a wall in Bangalore. And so that itself was a lot of discussion, and then there was of course a lot of appreciation. Of course there was a lot of backlash also, some backlash, because people are not used to seeing transgender people's faces on art forms, especially as a mural in a public space. But our whole point was that to not run away from something that we need to accept. We are always like trying to avoid them, you know, wherever we have to encounter people from the community, we want to avoid them. We want to avoid looking at them so that they don't come and ask us something. So I think that avoidance is what was creating a lot of friction to begin with. And I think everybody knows that we always will criticize, or we'll try to negate things that we don't understand. So what is it that we could do to make people understand in a very, very small way, in a very human way, not to preach them and teach them the science of transgenderism, but to just tell them that maybe they like dosa like you do, they like food, I mean, they like colors that you do, and, you know, to connect in a more friendlier manner and not treat them as a topic of discussion or to put them in a pedestal because they seem different to us, and more working with them, I realized that they don't want to be treated differently. that's what they're fighting for. And even then, whenever we meet them or we are doing something together, everybody's like paying more attention to them, and they're like, oh, are you okay, are you comfortable? And all of that lasts for a very very short time. It's not genuine. People are doing it because they'll get something out of it, they'll get an interview by the end of it, you know, and after that that person is forgotten, right? So I think what worked well with doing something like this is that we all had a project to complete. And regardless of who you are, what gender you are, doesn't matter, the project has to get completed. So that itself gave them a lot of confidence and like some sense of responsibility, which they've never been trusted with before. Nobody trusts them with a responsibility. And I'm talking about nobody in the sense that other people from the society. Within their community, of course, they have a lot of sisterhood and friendship, which is so underrated, which I saw so much of it, and I realized that we need to be a bigger community, and it's not just the transgender being a community. Like, women should join them and men should join them, everybody should join them, because that's what they wanted. They don't want to be treated as a separate community. So some of the projects that we've done on those lines have been in Delhi, in Lodi Garden, Lodi Art District, and in Chennai we did one recently, and this year we did one very big community-based project in Dharavi. There have been paintings everywhere. We also traveled to San Francisco and painted a mural at the Facebook headquarters 2 years ago. We worked ground level into like rural schools with the transgender people, and not with the notion of going there and preaching to them that transgenders are good and amazing, nothing. We just go there to do our work, we paint. And when people see them doing some work and painting, the respect is very different. It doesn't have to come with me telling you, look at what they're doing. You will see it yourself and you will develop that sense of respect and that change in the way of thinking by yourself. And that's what we wanted to initiate with everything we do.
Poornima, that's great, and a lot of admiration for you and your entire team, because as you mentioned, we are doing it in a way which is very human, which is very harmless. It is not about enforcing something or preaching about it or telling. Let people just come out and see for it on their own that this is what is possible, can be done. And what you mentioned is very something, you know, natural, that they are not normally trusted. Or you make it a topic of discussion, or see them as in a myopic way, it's just one community. But having similar emotions, sentiments around life like anybody else would have, and treating that as normally as we can. And Poornima, if at this time, like you were mentioning, your work has been hit in a very bad way. A lot of projects have been come to a standstill, and things may not work out in the near future. So what are some of the possible, because mural painting is all about working on a large scale and long-term. So what possibilities are you exploring as a director of this project, that things can be done and there is a little bit of digression here and there?
So one thing that we started last year deliriously because of, with the help of a grant, was to also explore. You can hear me, right?
Yeah, I can.
Okay. So one thing that we've explored like last year because of a grant that we received was to experiment on different kinds of, you know, mediums of art apart from the mural, which was really helpful for us to gain insight on a lot of research work that is going into the kind of work we do. It's not just coming and painting a wall, because there's so much of culture and tradition and history involved in the transgender community in India that it is just never ending. It's a very, very huge topic to discover, and it's very beautiful and it's very colorful, and it has different cultural backgrounds. The transgender people from Karnataka have very different practices from the transgender people in Jaipur, for example, or they have very different practices with people in like the Northeast. So I mean, we haven't even begun exploring that because we have so much to do in South India at the moment itself. We've of course reached till Bombay in terms of our research, but now we're slowly exploring Gujarat, and all of this is research based. So a lot of that possibility still is intact. we get the trans women themselves to, you know, make calls and teach them to do research online about these communities, and they are aware, they've heard of something somewhere. So then we go and Google it and we do some research about it. So everybody is in the loop in terms of research. That work is not stopping anymore. Because we want to continue exploring those stories. Now for us, it is for all of us as a collective to think about what are the ways we can put these stories out. If not mural, can we put them out as like big paintings on canvases? Maybe bigger size paintings. And you know, maybe we can do like some interactive websites, or we can do some, you know, like maybe small panel discussions only within the cultural realm, or audio record some of the things that. This is a very interesting time, also sad but interesting, that a lot of tradition and culture, because it involves gathering, is going to disappear. So it's a good time for us to document these as stories or as visuals, and collect these material in some form to make people understand that this was so strong and it has always existed. It's not something that started like 1999. Nobody can say that the transgender culture existed as much as we all have, but we've not paid attention to it, so a lot of it has already disappeared. So we want to at least document and throw some light on what is remaining and what are the beautiful parts of it, what are the interesting parts of it. So our research work still continues, and we are definitely painting a lot of canvases, and you know, we're putting them up on sale. This is also to increase some sort of a confidence level for our trans artists. And all of this is available on our Instagram. We are always online and ready for discussions. We are doing lots of panel discussions. We are part of all the Pride activities that are happening. So yeah, there is work happening. I'm not saying everything has to be money generating, but although that has to be somewhere included. So we are writing grants, we are doing as many possible things. And mural is not an impossible task, because it doesn't involve everybody to be in a crowd. Everybody will be actually working in their respective stations. So we are also trying to pitch that idea that, you know, it only requires 3 or 4 people on site, and we'll be executing something on our own, and it doesn't involve so many people, because like I said, if it's a scaffolding, we'll all be sitting in our own stations and doing our work with the, you know, required safety gear and everything else. So I hope that there is something in the pipeline soon, and whenever there is, you'll know it. Like, the best place to know it is Instagram at the moment.
Now I hope this works out, because what you mentioned, even as you said, it may not be generating money instantly, but something very valuable is happening, the research around it. And as you rightly mentioned, that it's not right, like, you know, something which is a recent development. It has existed with us from the ancient times, and nobody maybe has really gone to that length to explore what the history has been like, what changes, trends do we see. And documenting that, I think, is going to be very precious work that is going to come out of it. And I hope that whatever you know, possibilities you are exploring in terms of painting canvases and bringing that out, and trying to evolve newer ways of expression, that even at this time, I think it's a great work happening. And thanks a lot, Poornima, for sharing all of these, and I really hope that more and more you know, nuances come out of this learning for you and for the entire community. Thank you so much for being on Her Stories. Any closing thoughts you have, please share with us.
I don't know. I mean, as much as we can, I know all of us are going through a tough time, but it's important that we lend our support to somebody, anybody who is close to you, and not to just turn a blind eye. It's easy to be ignorant right now, and I know it's an easy way out to just think that, oh, I don't want to know these bad news, and I know I don't want to pay attention to the news because I'm going to feel bad. It's not about, it's a lot about also making sure that there is something that you play, there is some role that you play in making things better for somebody around you. It could be anyone. And I think it's important to try and think like that, even if we are all personally going through difficult times. It'll just make things a little lighter for yourself, for sure, when you help somebody. and it will definitely help the other person. So I think my piece of advice would be just don't be ignorant by choice so much so that you are, you know, like lost in your own bubble. A little awareness is good.
I completely agree. And I think, as you mentioned, that even if it is making a small difference or to one person, lending that support is very important. And it is very easy at this time to feel that, you know, I'm the one who's suffering. But if you see around you, the world is, it's a global pandemic we are going through. It's a battle against like the global issue that has come up.
Yeah.
Thanks a lot, Purnima. And I wish you a very good luck, that I hope all the projects that you are envisioning at this moment and whatever work is in the pipeline sees the best form. Thank you for being on Her Stories.
Thank you.